the price, this laptop should not be this good. Seriously, it really shouldn't. In this video, I'll be unboxing the VivoBook S16 OLED, giving you my first impressions, telling you some of the settings you should change in my setup guide, and even sharing some of the games that I've been playing on this laptop. But first, hi, I'm Captain Awesome, this is Geekception, and I really appreciate if you hit the like button and subscribe as it really helps me out here on this channel. Let's start with the unboxing. On the front of the box, we have ASUS VivoBook S here, and it comes in recycled packaging, which is always nice to see. Getting into the box, and up top I see a section you can tear out, which you can literally convert into a stand. Like, a stand is included in the literal box. I see the VivoBook S16 OLED, which we'll come back to in a while. Next, I see manuals. You're going to read all the user guide manuals, right? Right? There's also a My ASUS leaflet included here. And lastly, in the box is a 90 watt charger. Okay, back to the VivoBook S16 OLED. And while it may not be as expensive as the Zen Book, this laptop here sure feels premium in the hand. And when you flip it underneath, you see some of the vents as well as a riser here. Okay, we've unboxed the laptop. What are some of the standout specifications here? Well, it's got a vibrant 3.2K OLED display here, which is absolutely stunning. So you can expect a smooth display with deep blacks and very vibrant colors. And for the processor, it either comes with an Intel Core Ultra 5 or a Core Ultra 7 processor. And it is paired with 16GB of RAM and 1TB of storage. And sadly, that is the maximum RAM you're going to get on this 16GB. And we know that the Core Ultra processors are pretty efficient, but you are also getting a 75 watt hour battery here, which ASUS claims will give you at least 16 hours of battery life. And for weight, it comes in at just 1.5 kg, so this is really light. And for the other variant, it also has a 14 inch variant as well. And for what is special about this VivoBook S OLED is that it has a RGB keyboard as well as a dedicated Copilot AI key. Because, you know, AI. Next, let's take a quick tour of the device here. And on the left side, you have the HDMI port, two USB-C ports, a micro SD card slot, and a combo audio jack. And yes, I am not a fan of the micro SD card slot. On the right hand side, there are only two ports and they are both USB ports. And now for my setup guide, these are some of the settings I recommend you change on the VivoBook S16 OLED right here. And we're going to start with my ASUS app. So first, open the My ASUS app. Go to the system update tab, and you might have updates here waiting for you. And if you do, download them, and you might have to restart. Okay, in case you restarted, open the My ASUS app again. If not, then just continue as you are. Go into device settings and turn on battery care mode. Now, what this does is it will limit your charge to 80%, and in the long run, it will actually preserve your battery health. So yeah, this is a setting not just for now, but for the future as well. Yes, you will not get, you know, that 16 hours. Maybe you'll be getting closer to 12 hours, but your battery life in the long run will thank you. So turn that on. Next, scroll down to ASUS OLED Care and make sure you toggle on pixel refresh. Automatically hide Windows taskbar in desktop mode, and Windows taskbar transparency effect are all turned on. Because this is an OLED display, it is susceptible to burning out, and turning all of these settings will make sure that you preserve the health of your display in the long run. And for my last recommendation in the My ASUS app, I would say scroll back up and go to the memory allocated to GPU. Select 8 gigs as your memory size, as this will make sure that your GPU is getting as much memory as possible, and you can get great performance in games as well, or, you know, graphic intensive apps like video editing or what have you. And it will prompt you to restart, so restart your PC and you are good to go. Okay, next, let me talk about my first impressions of this device. Now, starting with the display here is simply gorgeous. This 3.2K OLED display, I've seen it on the ZenBook 14 before, and just like on the ZenBook 14, on here it's simply gorgeous. I enjoyed watching so much in just my first, like, you know, few hours with this laptop. Next, let's talk about the keyboard, which I'll be honest, I really like it, especially in this colorway, this blue colorway here. I just like how the blue here looks with the contrast here. It really looks good. There's also single zone RGB, which means that, you know, there's one color which you can change the entire, you know, RGB here, which to be honest, it was a head scratcher for me. I'm not a fan, and, you know, most of the time, I think for me personally, I'll just turn this to just white as my default color. But yeah, there is RGB if you want it as well. There's also a dedicated Copilot key for AI. Don't get me wrong, I use AI a lot, especially, you know, helping me with my videos here on the channel, but I just cannot bring myself to use Copilot. beyond just testing it out, you know, in my day-to-day, I think I'm really not going to use this button at all. And as for the trackpad, we have a massive MacBook-like trackpad here, thankfully, on the VivoBook S16, which I think is one of the nice features of this laptop. Now, moving on to the camera, it has a Windows Hello compatible IR sensor, so you can use this to, you know, log into your computer. And I actually did a camera test as well. Check it out. And this is a sample test of the front camera of the VivoBook S16 OLED right now. Let me know what you feel about the audio as well as the video quality as well. I'm in my studio. I have a light right above me right here. And like, this is just my studio space. And when I turn on automatic framing, I can be able to move out and move into the frame right here. And you can see it will attempt to keep me centered. Now, I'm not quite sure how useful this will be, but this is there for the people that want automatic framing right here. And there's also eye contact. So maybe I'm looking down there. I'm not sure. I cannot see myself. So I'm just looking at other parts of the laptop here for you to be able to see if it actually corrects my eyes and focuses my eyes there. Let me know. And finally, the background effects. So there is the standard blur, which I think this looks like very fake. And there is the portrait blur, which looks, I think this is the one I would go for. So combine all of those things together, and this is what you, this is what you get, except of that weird pulsing there, but this is not what you get here. What did you think of the camera and audio test? Please let me know in the comments down there below. Now, the power brick of this VivoBook S16 OLED is actually 90 watts compared to, let's say, other ASUS devices I've used, which come with 65 watts, which means that theoretically you should be able to pull more power with this VivoBook S16 OLED when you are plugged in. And lastly is the speakers. I carried out a sound test. Check it out. Okay, coming back from that sound test, and I would definitely say that I had high hopes for the speakers here, especially considering how good the one on the ZenBook 14 OLED were. But I was a little bit disappointed, especially in the bass. I think there's just not enough bass, and it's loud, but I think it could also be louder, or the quality is just not there. So I think speakers here are not bad, but they're also not the best. Okay, moving on to gaming. And I played some games here on the VivoBook S16 OLED, like, you know, Wuthering Waves, which is a new game that is all the rave now, Cyberpunk 2077, Genshin Impact, and even GTA 5. And I'll be playing some clips from my gaming test of the VivoBook S16 OLED on screen right now, but I really recommend you go check out my full gaming video, which if it's not up now, it will be up like within this week, or it will be on my channel if you're watching this in the future, because I found out some things about this laptop and gaming that are slightly concerning. Okay, nearing the conclusion of this video, what do I think of the VivoBook S16 OLED? And I'll be honest with you, I really liked this laptop when it was announced. I like the price point, I like the size, I like the weight, I like the feature set. I pretty much like many of the combinations of what makes this laptop, such as, you know, the 3.2K OLED display, the large trackpad, which I am definitely grateful for, the RGB keyboard and the dedicated Copilot key for AI. But just in general, you know, my first impressions when I first went to the launch and when I'm unboxed it, when I've been using it, is just like, okay, I like it. I like the combination together. And like I said earlier in this video, there's a 14-inch variant as well, in case you want to check that out, as well as the price for this laptop on screen right now. Let me know what you think of the VivoBook S16 OLED. Are you getting it? I know that they've just announced, you know, a AMD version with other AI features or whatever. So let me know if you're considering that one as well, or if you already have this laptop, what are your experiences with it? Let me know in the comments down there below. And as always, I've been your Captain of Awesome. I would really appreciate if you like the video, if you subscribe. It's free, you don't have to pay anything. But if you had some money and you wanted to buy me a coffee, you wanted to buy me lunch, I really appreciate, you know, following the links down there below to my PayPal, to my Ko-fi page. I'd really appreciate it, as you know, I do this as a labor of love. This is like 5:55 a.m. in the morning here. So I really love doing this, and I would really appreciate any small thing that you are able to give here. But enough of that. Thank you so much for checking this video out. I've been Captain Awesome. This is Geekception. And please don't forget to text me when you get home so I know you got home safe. I'll catch you in the next one. Don't forget to stay awesome. Bye.